Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. It's Brett Tadlock, TN Artist here. Just wanted to share this painting with you real quick of this ocean scene. So the key things with starting something like this that I'm learning more and more with my paintings is to start with a tinted canvas, so that way you're not working against the white. You can see your values better. And then kind of figure out what your palette is. Work with a limited palette. So what I'm working with here are some yellows. Basically a yellow, a purple, a blue, and a couple different browns, like a burnt sienna, burnt umber kind of thing, and then white as well. So when I build this out, what I'm using, the brushes I'm using are the default brushes that come with Procreate. I'm using the oil brush because it has kind of a nice buttery smear. Then I'm using the gouache brush because it lets you lay down different levels of color. The same thing with, and then I'm using the watercolor brush on top, which kind of gets some of the smeariness out of the oil brush. So I'm laying all those down, and then I take and smear the color on my canvas below there, and then sample the color that I want. That's how I get my dark tones. I will smear a color over top of it, then I'll sample it, and then I'll use that to go into it. And what that allows me to do is make sure that I'm using colors from the painting as the painting's progressing, and really keep the color harmony going throughout the painting, because the colors that I'm using in my palette are pulled directly from it. I'm not sampling from something else or pulling in just colors that don't make sense. So even when I'm getting like this greenish color and these blues, it's by taking it from that limited palette, smearing it on there, sampling it, and then using that to build up the colors. So the key focus here is really the sun and that light source coming through. So I'm trying to think about that and lay in the different colors that I want, but keeping the idea of, okay, here's where my wave's gonna be, so I'm that kind of tangerine look. I wanna get in some blues and some purples, because that would still have some of that reflection from the sky, like above, even though the main atmosphere is kind of this yellowish tone. I still want hints there of the other colors that are there. So I've got that green and blues and purples kind of going in there, plus they're complementary colors to the warm yellows and oranges, and so it really kind of helps everything pop from there. So thinking about where the color's flowing, where the light's flowing, and everything else, and kind of softening stuff and go through. So the one smudge tool that I use is the wet sponge tool. And so I use that to kind of soften edges and blend everything together. And really right now what you're looking at is the underpainting and laying out the composition for where I want everything to be, and not fiddling around with any details really. I actually have this zoomed out on my iPad and making sure that I don't dive into details and get lost into those. So I'm building up and thinking about, okay, how are the waves flowing? How is everything going and moving around? And again, by sampling the colors that are on the palette and then playing with, you know, the values. Now, values are your light to dark, and you have your hues, which are the colors. So playing with the values to really pull in my composition for where the light source is going to be, but also grabbing the hues that are in the painting and then different values of those hues to lay in the shadows and the foam and the direction it's going and everything else for that, and then use that to then build up my rocks and my layers and my details. And so trying to really mess around with some of that and get that look and feel that I want. One of the things that I do with the rocks later on that you can see is that I'll actually use one of the spatter brushes to put in dots on a separate layer. All of this pretty much right now has been done on one layer. So I'm just painting on one layer, and I've gotten to where I really only use like three or four layers at most. And so one of the things anyway I'll do is I'll take one of those spatter brushes and I'll spatter in the highlight color that I want or the shadow color I want, and then I'll use the warp tool to pull that and stretch it and twist it. And it almost gives you that same look that you get with a palette knife, like you see when Bob Ross, you know, or Bill Alexander, they kind of put in those mountains and stuff and had that breaking paint. It gives me a similar effect with that. But other than that, I'm really using the brushes and just painting in what I want, these highlights and stuff. So, and right here, I am doing highlights of the light. Again, that's my main focus, is so I have that line going straight back to it. I have the waves kind of crossing, coming across to it, and really directing the eye back towards that as I build it up. So if you need to get a good circle, you know, of course in Procreate you can draw and hold a circle and then hold it and it'll make it a nice circle. Or you can just use, like I do, is a lot of times I'll just use the airbrush tool because that's a circle anyway. And I'll tap it and put a nice circle there. And if I'm using something like this where it's the sun or things like that, I'll use the softer brush so I get that natural glow around it. But right here is where I'm starting to pull in some of the details and really kind of get the work towards the final stuff. So I start very loose, very open, very free, build up the colors and the idea of the composition. From there, start pulling into the details of it and really playing around with it, making sure that I don't do those at the beginning because you can get lost in those details. So one of the tips I would give you for this so far is start with a tinted canvas so that way the white doesn't show through. You can tell more accurately what your highlights and darks are. Build up from that with a loose color palette and start going into it. And then, oh, by the way, this right here that you see with this gray that I'm putting there, I actually talked to an artist friend of mine. He was saying, what if you vignetted it? And which just means outer edges are darker and you kind of see the inside. And so I tried that. I didn't like it. So I took it back out. And then he mentioned about what if you put more of the yellow and the mustardy kind of reflections down in the water below. Again, tried it, didn't like it. But it's good to get feedback, somebody else to look at it and see it another opinion. But anyway, so what I was saying was with this, was start with a limited palette, build up your colors, sample your colors throughout the painting, and use those to start really building out what you want it to look like. So that's right here. This is the part I was talking about where I'm doing this, the spatter brush and then warping it to get that pull of like a palette knife. And playing around with that. So, you know, don't overly use the tools. I mean, you can, but personally, I don't want to rely on the technology too much. I just want to find a way to make it do what I want it to do. And part of that is doing the warping of it to get that palette knife kind of thing. So one thing right here, you see that gray that is over the rocks right there that's in the atmosphere? That was for me zooming in and working on those rocks and not realizing that my smudging tool was blending that over into my sky. So when I zoomed out, I saw it, and then I took the lasso tool and just removed it because those highlights and stuff I was doing on a separate layer because I wanted it to be like I was painting on dry paint below it so that way it wouldn't change it too much. So anyway, but that's one of the things about it. You know, you can go back and change stuff and move it around and do it. That's one of the great things about working with digital is that you have the capability to really play around with it. And so I thought some birds in the background would be kind of cool thing to add in. So I'm adding those in and then just kind of getting the feel for it and checking the atmosphere. So the whole point of this painting is the sun, the light, the atmosphere, and really capturing that look and feel of that. So anyway, I hope this has helped at least kind of give you an over the shoulder kind of view of what I'm doing and how I do it and my thought process with it. So if you have questions or comments, I try to answer as soon as I can. Sometimes I don't get the notifications, but I do try to answer everything that I can to answer the questions. Also, we've got the Facebook group where we answer a lot of questions and comments there and have different files that you can download and stuff. But really enjoying Procreate and working a lot with it. I'm going to put some others up. My other two favorite programs are Rebel 4 and ArtRage. So I'll be putting up some tutorials for those very shortly. But I hope you like this. Hope you give it a thumbs up. Make sure to like and subscribe and, you know, ring the bell for notifications, all that standard stuff. And I appreciate you taking the time to watch, and I really enjoy all your comments and suggestions. So thanks.